वेलकम टू दिस लेक्चर। द मिनिएचराइजेशन मशीनिंग एंड द फिजिकल सिस्टम हैज़ बीन इंटेंसिफाइड इन द रिसेंट ईयर एज मार्केट डिमांड्स फॉर इंटेलिजेंट रॉबस्ट मल्टी फंक्शनल एंड द लो कॉस्ट कंज्यूमर प्रोडक्ट हैज़ बीन मोर स्ट्रॉन्ग देन एवर। एवरी वन वॉन्ट सिस्टम दैट इज मोर इंटेलिजेंट और more and more functions should be in that. It should be robust and it should be as cheapest as possible, low cost. So for the fulfilling these requirements, it is required to miniaturize the machine and the physical systems. In this era of think small, one would intuitively simply scale down the size of all the components to a device to make it small. All devices earlier we have seen that there was a big computers, now small laptops, palm tops are there. Initially there was big size of phone, telephones, the receiver system different, and one is system is different. We have already seen the old telephones. But now small mobile phones are in your hand, and also along with this the smart watches are there, so with many functions in that. So what is the size of all the components of the devices reducing there? So there are the both positive and the negative physical consequences of the scaling down the machine and the devices. The scaling law becomes the very first things that any engineer would do in the design of MEMS and microsystems. He must know what are the positive and the negative consequences of scaling the devices, and after keeping this in mind, he can reduce the size of that devices. Scaling in the geometry, we can see if we can consider L is the linear dimension of a solid. Then what is the volume? Volume is L cube, or we can say that's length multiplied by width multiplied by height, that is a volume. And what is the surface? That is L square. So we can what is the ratio of that one? That ratio of that one, that it will be S upon V. We can take that is L inverse. For example, V is a volume, that is width multiplied by thickness or height multiply by length. So all are length, so we all are proportional to linear dimension. These are linear dimensions, L proportionality. So we can write the V proportional to L cube and S proportional to L square, and we can write ratio of S upon V, surface upon volume, that will be equals to L inverse. So if we reduce the size by 10 times, what will happen? The volume will be reduced by 1000 times and the surface area will reduce by 100 times. So the ratio of S upon V, that will be reduced by, increased by 10 times. So we can see from here that since the volume relate to the mass and surface area S related to bounce function force. So because of this, we can see that S upon V for this, we can see this is a big element here. S upon V is 10^-4 per mm. This is 10^-4 per mm. And S upon V for this butterfly is for insect, that is for 10^-1 per mm. Because of this, elephant can never fly and easily as a dragonfly, because for the dragonfly the Bionz force is more relative to this one, surface area, this volume. Okay, so Bionz force is a main important player, important role to fly for a dragonfly. If the Bionz force is more, object will move upward in the liquid or in the gaseous medium. Just take an example for scaling the geometry. What will happen to the required torque to turn a micro mirror with a 50% reduction in the size? What will be the effect if we will reduce the size of a mirror by 50% on the effect of the torque to turn the mirror, micro mirror. So the torque that is proportional to IYY, that is mass momentum of the inertia of the mirror. That's we have already seen earlier that IYY, mass moment inertia of the mirror about y axis, that is 1 by 12 of into mc square, where what is the c? C is the width. This is, so we can write m is the mass of the mirror and c is the width of this mirror. This one, this is the width, c width. So but the mass of the mirror m, that is rho, what is rho? Rho bc into t. This is complete for rho multiplied by bct. This is volume, bc into t, this thickness, height and this width. So this is mass multi, is a rho multiplied by this one. The rho is the mass density of the mirror. So density multiplied by volume, that will give the complete mass of this material. So we can write the we can replace m by rho into bct multiplied by c. What is c? This is c square. So we can write the formula, that is IYY equals the mass momentum inertia, that is equals 1 by 12 multiplied by rho into bc cube t. One c this one and this is c square, so c cube t will be here. A 50% reduction in size would result in the following. What will affect? This is 1 by 12 in the rho, this is x. B, new b is b by 2, this is c by 2 cube and this is t by 2. So we will get 1 by 32 into 1 by 12 bc rho into bc cube t. This is the original value IYY. So we seen here that the in the new value I dash YY, that is 1 by 32 times of IYY. So we can say that a factor of 32 times reduction is required torque to rotate the mirror. So if we reduce the size of this one, the dimensions by 50%, the torque that is required, that is lesser by 32 times of the previous torque to rotate this mirror. The scaling in the rigid body dynamics. The rigid body dynamics is applied in the design of micro actuator and the micro sensors. Examples are micro accelerometer, or we can say inertia sensor. The size effect requires the force and thus power in the performance of these devices. If the size will change, the force and the power will be also be changed. The dynamic force acting on rigid body in motion with acceleration A or deceleration can be computed from Newton's second law, that is F square equals to M into A. M is the mass, A is the acceleration or deacceleration of this material. So acceleration A in the Newton's law now can be expressed in the following way. You can see in the scaling, let this displacement of the rigid body S is proportional to L, that is displacement S. So we can measure it in form of L, in which L is a linear scale. So we can write the velocity of this body, that is V equals to S upon T, displacement by time, and hence V is proportional to L multiplied by T inverse, L multiplied by T inverse, in which it is the required time. T is the required time. T is the required time to move rigid body by displacement S. So we can write S upon T. S is the maybe expressed in form of L, and T is the T inverse because it's for upon T. From the particle kinematics, we have S equals V naught T plus half T AT square. This is the equation for displacement. You already know this one. We have already studied earlier classes. So S equals to V naught T plus half AT square. Here initial velocity V naught, that is zero, we are assuming. So we can write S equals to 1 upon 2 AT square, or A is equal to 2S upon T square. We can write the equation of A from here. So the scaling of the dynamics for force F, we can write the equation for F, that is M into A, M into 2S upon T square. Here the dimensions, 2 is constant value, S for this one we can write L, for M we can write L Q Y. This is rho multiplied by B C T. We already studied there. Length multiplied by width multiplied by height. So we can write it's Q L Q for this one, and for T minus 2. These are the in the form of dimension length. We can write F. Now the power density P upon V square V naught, that is the design practice power density, rather than we are using in the designing of MEMS power density instead of power. Power is defined as energy produced or spent by the device per unit time. Now energy is a rated to work which is equals to the force equivalent to move a mass by distance. To move a mass by distance, that is known as energy, and energy per unit time spent by the device per unit time, that is known as power. So we can write the equation P upon V naught, that is F into S, that is energy divided by per unit time T multiplied by 1 upon V naught. So P is equal to Fs upon T. We have divided by both sides by V naught, we will get this one, where S the displacement of the mass moved by the force, and T is the time during energy is produced. So the scaling in the mechanical domain, we can see from this here that the weight of a beam is a distributed load equals to Q, that is Q is a distributed load where equals to rho m into A into G, Newton per meter. So it is, where is rho m? That is mass density of the material. Mass density of the material. A is the area, cross-sectional area, and G is the acceleration due to gravity. So assume that the beam has rectangular cross-section of dimension A1L into A2L, width into height. So we can write it AL, A1L into A2L. These are coefficient, A1 and AL is the length, A1, A2 are the constant for proportionality to width and height. According to the beam theory, the maximum deflection of the beam which occur at its midpoint, that is given by delta equals to Q into L power 4 divided by 384 EI. This is the maximum deflection of the beam, where Q is the weight of the beam, L is the length, 384, E the Young modulus, I is the moment of inertia. This area where I value, we have already seen that it's 1 upon 12 into WHQ, that is for rectangular beam. So putting these values, what is we can replace W by A alpha 1L H alpha 2L, so whole cube, then we will get alpha 1 alpha 2 cube L 4 divided by 12, this value, and the cross section area, that is A is equal to alpha 1 L into alpha 2L. So we will get this equation. Now sorry, the delta value, that is rho g, delta V value, that is what is this delta value, Q into L4 upon 384 EI. So Q, what is Q? Q into equals rho PM into A, this is value of Q, multiply by L4 divided by 384 EI. So 384, this is E or Y, we can write for Young modulus, and I, this is I. So what is del upon I? Del upon L, we have calculated, we have also divided both side by L, this is L, this is L. So what we will get, this is rho g into rho m A into alpha power 4 divided by 384 y I into L. Y is the Young modulus here, 12 into g, we have just on similar, again writing the value for this one, what is value of I? We can write value for this one. So what is value of I? We can write 1 upon 12 into alpha 1 alpha 2 cube L4. So 1 upon 12 alpha 1 alpha 2, this is sorry alpha 1 and I value alpha 1 L into alpha 2 L cube divided by 12, this is value, and g rho m a, that is alpha 1 alpha 2 into l square, this is value, and l4, and this is L, this one. So on this solution, solving it, we will get rho g into rho m, and this will be cancelled, and the, what will be finally, we will get g rho m into L upon 32 yi into alpha 2 into square, alpha 2 square, this is, or this we will get. So sorry, I will replace, so there will be no I, this is 1, we can consider it as a 1, and this is proportional to L. So we can write here from this derivation, we can see these equations solutions, or we can see that this is delta upon L, that is equal proportional to L. So we can say that the relative deflection is proportional to the size of the beam. So if 1 meter long beam has a relative deflection of 0.01, 1 mm long beam will have a relative deflection of 0.01 multiplied by 10 raised to the power minus 6, because we are reducing the size 1 meter and 1 mm. So hence we can conclude that the effect of self weight of the microsystem structure is negligibly small, is because there is very small effect of weight on this deflection, relative deflection. Now we will see that we will calculate the stress effect on the stress and the strain. So what is the maximum stress in the cantilever beam due to its own weight is given by MC upon I. We already calculated in previous lectures. So sigma max, that is equals to MC upon I, or sigma x, we have written there MY upon I. So what is the C? That is H by 2. If total height of this material, the beam, is H instead of C by 2C, we can write here C is equal to H by 2. Here M equals to Q into L square, because it's the maximum bending moment of a fixed beam. And Q is rho M G into A, we have already seen. We can write sigma max equal to QL square into C. What is PH into L? This is coefficient divided by 2 upon this I. We can write PI into I4. And by again replacing Q with G into rho M into PA into L square. This is replacing Q, and this is L square for L square, PHL upon 2pi into L4. So on solving, we will get this equation, and this is, we can see the finally it's proportional, sigma max is proportional to L, where PA is a proportionality constant for area, PH proportionality constant for height or thickness, and PI proportionality constant for moment of inertia. So this is the relation we have got, and we can say from this one that the maximum stress due to the self weight is proportional to the size. If we will increase the we will double the size, the self stress will be doubled. Later, this more effects of the scaling in other domain we will see in the next lecture. Till then, thank you.